Hi, this is Vicky, also known as DragonflySoars7673. You're watching DragonflySoars, and I'm recording this on Monday, August 26th, and it's about 5:40 in the evening. Hopefully, because this is a little earlier than I have been the last couple weeks, there won't be the sun shining across my face. I apologize so much for the lighting last week. I didn't realize until I played it back that it went from sun across my face to good to dark, and by the time I saw it, and it was so long, I just put an apology in the front and called it good. I really didn't want to redo it. But I have a lot to show you, and I did not record last week, obviously. So I'm not sure what I said before. The last time I recorded, the lighting was bad. It was not last week, though. Last week, I had totally forgotten that Monday we were going to baseball game. Several people in my knit group, and then Allison, who is legal girl, who lives down in St. Louis. Best friend and I met her down in St. Louis when we took our trip in June. She was visiting Milwaukee. So a bunch of us from knit group, Allison, myself, and then my son and best friend all went to the Cardinals versus Brewers baseball game. Allison and best friend are huge Cardinals fans. My son and I can pretend, mostly because we don't care one way or the other. And then everybody else was Brewers fans, so we were helping even out the odds. So I didn't record on Monday. Tuesday I was going to record, and my son pointed out that it was the last day that he and I would have together, just two of us, before he left, because most other nights best friend is around, which is perfectly good. They get along, but my son was like, Mom, I really would like to spend the last day with you, and I said, and at that point I said I wasn't going to record. So, there has been a lot of stuff going on. I have kind of this whole variety of things to tell you, and I've been trying to figure out kind of the best way, but let's just start with, I got a bunch of knitting done, but it's all pretty, mostly easy knitting. So, I got my August green socks done. So, I just finished them this past weekend when my son went back to my mom's house, and I finished the second sock while I was there. They're still damp right now, but I am very proud. They start on a different color on the toe, but the stripes themselves match up really well. I used every last little bit of yarn. When I was done with each skein, there was this little tiny bit of the gray color of each of them. So I couldn't, there was no way I could start and stop on the same color without like cutting off from the other end, and it's not worth it. So, but the stripes line up really nice. The heels look nice. So I'm really glad with it, really happy with how they came out. So that is for the August birthstone along. My other item for the August birthstone along, I have been spinning the green Uniquely Yours bat, and somewhere I lost the card that came with it that listed all the different kinds of fiber. But anyway, this was the one I got from Kagi TM of the High Fiber Diet, and this is the singles. Now this part looks pretty thin. Not all of it is. Some of it's all different. It's because each section of fiber spun differently. So this section spun pretty thin. There's another section that was kind of sticky, and it did not spin nearly so thin. But anyway, it needs to be plied. But it'll be done this week. So that is for August for the Peridot birthstone along projects. And we've had a lot of entries So I'm really glad you have until this Saturday. Well, when I get up on Sunday, on September 1st, that's when I'll lock the thread. Normally that would be about 6:30 if it was during the week, but because it's a Sunday, it will be whenever I get around to it, so you'll have a couple extra hours. In case anybody has forgotten, this is the prize for August. This was donated by Mountain Pearl. It is part of the Loopy U striping series, which I believe was a limited edition series. Anyway, and stitch markers. And when September comes, we have this beautiful bag designed and sewn by Livin' for Fishin', along with yarn that she donated and a little tin, and which is also from her. And then I'm throwing in some stitch markers just because, so you have something to put in the tin. So September's prize is pretty good. All this is for September. I've loved the donations. One of the July prizes was $15 worth of Ravelry. Anything $15 or less. Well, that was donated by I Am New York City Girl and one by Alchemy. Well, they actually worked together and they ended up with three different patterns. Two of them Alchemy had picked and the other one was a surprise. So, which I just thought was awesome. So that's all the Burstone Long stuff. I'm going to pause here for a second and put in pictures of the socks and the spinning. All right, since we're talking, September is sapphire, which is bright jewel tone blues. I purchased some fiber because I realized I didn't have a lot of jewel tone blue in my stash. I have a lot of teals. But these roll logs do have the sapphire blue in them. So I will count these. But I'm also doing this because Malia, who is known on Ravelry as Rhymes with Maria, of the Yarn Raising Podcast, is having a new to you spin along in September. And you can get entries for a new fiber prep, a new tool. I don't remember what else. But I thought I would try spinning these on my Turkish spindle next month. So that would be my new to me fiber prep in this case, and a new tool. So, and that will then count as one of my September items. All right. Oh, I forgot to say, remind you, these are the Verjeven socks. They were designed by Renee Strouts, and I was doing them as the as part of the knit along, which is kind of also a test knit. So that was that. I also have been working, as in maybe an hour today, but I did pull out the twitchy socks again. I left off at the ribbing, and the ribbing I can't really take with me to the movies and things like that, so they've just been sitting. So today I pulled them out and decided to start the ribbing. You can just barely see it. But I did pull them out and start working on them. Actually, partially because I was thinking it has this kind of limey greeny stripe and the bright green stripe, which means if I finish them, I could count them for another August project. So we'll see. This week's a little funky. I keep looking down at my notes because I'm trying to think of things. Oh! I had told you guys about the new spinning and fiber functionality in Ravelry that you could get by entering the swatch code and trying it out. Well, it is now actually available to everybody. So on your stash page, you can now see a fiber stash tab. You can convert yarn from, if you had things that you had stashed originally that were fiber, they show up right now on your yarn, and then you can say you want to convert them to fiber. Once you have fiber, when you have yarn, you can, or projects or whatever, you can say, okay, you pick a pattern, you say knit this or hook this. Well, now on fiber, there's a button that says spin this, I think. It says something like that. It's obvious when you look at it. And then you can go straight from a fiber into a spinning project. And you can start, you can put start dates and finish dates. When you mark it as finished, it then copies it over into your yarn stash. You'll actually see it in two places. You see it as a spinning project because it was a project you finished, and it becomes yarn, which you can then use in other projects for knitting, knitting or crochet. You can do multiple fibers into a single yarn. I haven't tried that feature, but you can do it. I have some from the past, but because I didn't realize this was coming, I actually accidentally converted them into all yarn and I can't convert them back. But anyway, there are a whole lot of features. I will link in the show notes where all the information is, or where there's, you know, threads of people talking about how to do stuff. So you can go play. I have, I have patterns to show you. I have so much to tell you that now I feel like I'm speeding through, but I think it's okay. This is a new pattern. Allison Ziegler, who's also known as A Texas Yarn on Ravelry, emailed me and several other podcasters, so you'll probably hear about this, about a new pattern she put out called A Little Help from My Friends. This is a pattern for socks with twisted stitches and lace. I'm going to read from here. These socks were inspired by a very good friend of mine who learned this past March that a CT scan, which was done to find why a torn muscle wasn't healing, led to the discovery of her stage 4 bladder cancer. Facing a rather poor prognosis, my friend has naturally found herself relying heavily on her family and friends for support, and we have all been doing what we can to get her through her devastating diagnosis and chemo treatments. This pattern represents one part of my way of showing support for my friend. She talks then about how the different types of stitches mean different things to her. But the important part is that this is a $5 pattern, but 50% is going to the Bladder Cancer Advocacy Network, or BCAN. I bought it myself. I have looked through it. It looks like a very well-written pattern. It has both charts and written instructions, but they're together. So there's written and chart, and then written and then chart. So it's very easy to follow. But aside from that, even if you don't buy the pattern, and I think you should buy the pattern. I think it's a good cause. I think it's a good pattern from what I can tell. Even if you don't, you should go check it out and find out and follow the rest of the information in the pattern, follow the links, and learn more about bladder cancer. Tiff and I, our godmother, had bladder cancer, and now she is doing well. Especially for women, it is often missed until it is very late. And this was something I didn't know until I was reading. It's missed until it's late because of the fact that it is often mistaken for menstruation. And even if it's kind of off cycle, especially as you're getting older, you just think you're, you know, going through the change, or we have a million, or stressed out, or whatever. We have a million reasons why things get screwed up. So we don't think that much of it until it's too late. So even if you don't buy the pattern, I do strongly recommend going and reading about the information. But again, if you buy the pattern, 50% will go to the Bladder Cancer Advocacy Network. And it's very hard to say. On a more cheerful note, one of the people in our group, her name on Ravelry is Artist Maybe. And several months back, when I was having you guys think about what you want to learn, what's something you want to do, which I have got to do an Andralock project because that was what I said I wanted to learn and I haven't done it yet. But she wanted to be a pattern designer. So we encouraged her, and I'd like to think that with our encouragement, she decided to go ahead and design a pattern. This pattern is called Summer Garden Trellis. And not only did she design it, but then Azad, who is Allison from Australia, who you've heard about because she's the one that thought of the birthstone along, she then test knit it for Mary. Her real name is Mary. So this pattern, Summer Garden Trellis, this is the picture on the pattern. And I'm actually going to post in right here a picture I stole of Allison's test knit because it's gorgeous. So just a second. All right. And I am going to assume that Allison is okay with me stealing that. So this pattern is $5 Canadian, which today came out to $4.88 US. And according to Allison, it was well written. They worked through some minor issues during the test knitting, but that's what test knitting is for. There's a beautiful chart. So that those are the charts, and there is also there's written instructions. I believe the written instructions on the chart go together. I haven't looked at it. It's knit in like three panels, which is why here you can see the different colors. Her first version of it was all one solid color, and Allison's is one solid color. This one is three colors because it shows you the different sections. I believe that was her plan. So go check that out. When I bought it today, this was her first pattern like this, and I did the PayPal, and it did sit at pending for a little bit because she's in Canada and I'm in the US. But as soon as she accepted my payment, I got the pattern right away. It's just one of those things that happens. Now, another pattern I got. Now, I told you guys that Ann Lena put a coupon code in our group for money off of her patterns. The pattern I got, I told you I got a pattern, but I didn't show you. This is Mistral. It has two versions in this pattern. There's a circular version, which is that one, and a crescent. Let me find the other picture. That's not very big, but that's the crescent version. I think both are gorgeous. The coupon is still going on. The coupon is good until August 30th. Now, in addition, Ann Lena has said that I can have two pattern prizes to give away however I want. So, the first one is totally a fun, no work, no knitting, no nothing contest. I was thinking the other day, and I don't even remember why it popped into my brain, But I have a book that's one of my absolute favorite books called Greensleeves. And it is by Eloise Jarvis McGraw. You can't find it on Amazon unless you want to pay a fortune. It hasn't been reprinted. When I was in high school, I kept seeing this book on the shelf. And I spent a lot of time in the library because that's where I like to spend my time. I spent way too much time reading and not enough time doing homework. And I would always see this book. And then I worked at the library, and they were actually going to throw the book away. And it had always kind of been in my mind, but it didn't have a jacket. I knew nothing about this book. It was just a yellow book with the name Greensleeves. I knew nothing about it. Well, when they were going to start clearing out books, and they were destroying some of the old books, because that's what happens sometimes, to make room for new ones, I asked the librarians if I could have it. And it ended up being one of my absolute favorite books. It's about a girl who is trying to kind of find herself. She's been moving back and forth all the time. And in the process of learning about other people, she finds out who she is. It is one of the only books I have ever read multiple times. It's just one of my favorites. So, I wanted to know what book or movie, or if you think of something else, but what book or movie do you absolutely love that nobody knows about? Because I know, like, this book, almost nobody knows about it. So, just tell me, what's your favorite book or movie that nobody knows about? Kind of like an undiscovered gem. Do that, and I will pick at random. I'll leave it open for a couple weeks. I will pick at random somebody to win a free pattern from Annalena. So that's one way to win her prize. Now, I said that she gave us two, and I need to pause this for a second. All right. The other way to win a pattern is by donating hats to JetGirl1313, Katie's campaign for Click for Babies. Purple hats. The Click for Babies campaign is all about knitting hats, baby hats. They have to be at least 50% purple. And if you donate hats to Katie and also post a picture of the finished hat in a thread for me, you will be entered for a prize. So, you got a couple things to do. When you knit a hat, post a finished picture in our group in the finished object thread. You get one entry per post. Now, Crow Julie has done 28 hats. She chose to count every four hats as one entry because she thought it would be unfair to do 28 entries. That was her choice. She and I talked about it. I would have been perfectly okay if she had done 28 entries because she made 28 hats. If you have a hat, or if you have a picture that has two hats in it, post it twice if you want two entries and title it one of two and two of two. You can see that I already did that in the thread for two hats that I made. So, like I said, Crow Julie, she has seven posts that have four each. She gets seven entries, even though she did 28 hats. That was because that was the way she chose to do it. She could have had 28 entries. So, make hats, post the finished object in our group. You get one entry per post. In our group, you can win the second Annalena pattern. That's one of the prizes. You can also win, this is my hand spun, this is Knittin in color, a beautiful sparkly turquoise black purple bat. It's kind of thick and thin, it's very hand spun rustic-y looking. But I think I did a good job on it. So, or you can win purple wool mice. At one point I tried to peel it off. I don't remember what color it is, but it's very definitely a red-purple color. So, there are three prizes you can win in our group by posting hats. Now, I did my these two hats are out of the Wool of the Knit Picks, Wool of the Andes Superwash that I said I was going to try. It knits up very similarly to Cascade 220 Superwash. It's about the same thickness. It's a little scratchier though. I haven't washed them yet to see if they will soften up. They're not super scratchy. They're not like I'm not worried about giving them to somebody for their kit. But it's scratchier than Cascade 220 Superwash. But it knits up about the same. This is actually, if you look at my pattern page, my standard hat pattern, I cast on 60. I knit 10 inches of 2x2 ribbing. I knit stockinette until it's approximately a square. And then I do decreases. This one, I just tied it off. This one, I made an I-cord. I ended up with just a little bit of purple left. I used the entire skein. It was a 50-gram skein for those two hats. And then I did... This is made of Dark Horse Fantasy. It's an acrylic blend of some sort. I had been saving it for purple hats. This one's a plain one. This one's a plain one with a I-cord doodab on the top. This one, I decided to get creative. It's very stretchy. It's got cables on it. Anyway, three of these. So, in one picture, I did these two, and I did two posts, one of two, two of two, and then I did these as three individual ones. So, I have five entries. When Tiff comes next week, she's bringing me a couple hats that she did because we're going to mail them all at once. So, in our group, just post a picture of the finished object. In Katie's group, she adds you to the contest when she receives it. So this, even though I've posted pictures, and she does have a finished object thread if you want to show off, but she doesn't count them until she gets them in her hands. Or if you are donating locally, and I don't know around here if there's a place to donate locally. If you are donating locally, you need to tell her, I knit this, but I'm donating locally to blah, 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 blah. You know, wherever you're donating. And then she'll add it to her spreadsheet. But she actually keeps a spreadsheet throughout this whole thing of the ones she receives or the ones she's been notified have been donated elsewhere. So if you don't want to post your finished objects, you just want to mail them, that's okay for her. When you mail them to Katie, if you have a printer, please include the tags. These tags can be found on her website under the quick links. In that same section is her address on where to mail the hats. So the tags say, they just go with the hats. If you can print them and tie them onto the hat, you know, punch a hole in them somewhere and tie them onto the hats if you can. And if you have extra tags, because they print four to a page, you can send them, because then if other people don't have printers, Katie will have some extra tags. But basically they're talking about that along with receiving the hat, people should then open the Period of Purple Crying program materials, which brings me to the next part. A few people have been wondering why purple. Purple represents a phase of babies. When they just cry. They cry for no apparent reason that makes any sense to anybody except for the baby. Because they keep crying and they don't stop, sometimes this results in shaken baby syndrome because people get so frustrated they shake. I can't imagine that most people who shook a baby until it, you know, ended up injured, brain damaged, did it on purpose. They're just frustrated. So, the letters for purple. P is peak of crying. Your baby may cry more each week, the most in month 2, and then less in months 3 through 5. You, unexpected, crying can come and go, and you don't know why. R, resist soothing. Your baby may not stop crying no matter what you try. P, pain-like face. A crying baby may look like it's in pain, even when they are not. L, long-lasting. Crying can last as much as 5 hours a day. And E, evening. Your baby may cry more in the late afternoon and evening. The one thing they want people to know is that this is a period. This is a phase. It's something babies are going through. They will get through it. You will get through it. Now, I have to be honest. I went to the website because I wanted to know more about why purple. Because I donated last year and didn't really think that much of it. So I wanted to know why purple. Well, on the same page that has the acronym, there are videos about crying babies and the purple phase, etc. And they're talking, you know, one of them has somebody coming home, you know, why is the baby crying? Every time I come home from work, he's always crying. The screaming, the crying baby in the videos started to get on my nerves. So you can definitely understand how a new parent would just be frustrated. And of course, not every baby goes through this. My son actually didn't really have this phase, but it's important for parents to realize it is a phase. So they give them purple hats and then all the materials to learn about this in an effort to help parents get through it and reduce the chances of shaken baby syndrome. Now, because Katie is the one running this, she is also going to have prizes. Like I said, she's going to be keeping track when hats come in. So I am donating two things to hers. So this is Lorna's Laces Shepherd Sock Purple Club. They are actually labeled as mill-ins. They, as near as I can tell, haven't found a single thing wrong or different about these, but they are labeled clearly as mill-ins. I think they're slightly short skeins is what it comes down to. I bought them from down in Chicago. This is a skein of Vavoom superwash wool and nylon 500 yards from CJ Kopek Creation. It has some purple in it, and also I know that I love CJ. And CJ and Heather Boutros Babe and Katie are all friends. So it just seemed fitting to donate this one as well. So these you can win from Katie. The foam mice, the hand spun, and the pattern from Aunt Lena, you can win from our group. So, all right. I'm trying to look real quick to see if I'm missing anything. Things I watched. I watched The Hobbit. I watched Kick-Ass 2 with my son and... My son and best friend really liked the first Kick-Ass movie and wanted to see the second one, so we saw it before my son left. Also, best friend has a huge man cave, and my son had really wanted to go see a movie, so we watched The Hobbit, which is why the title is it scrumptious? Because that's what Gollum says, and it just made me giggle. I'm going to show you Mom's doll. She finished her August doll, so I have those pictures to put at the end. I was going to do book reviews. I'm going to hold off on those. This just feels long enough. Best friend is downstairs. We would like to eat something. This weekend, Tiff is coming. So it's Labor Day, so we celebrate my son's birthday, so she's coming for that. And we have every plan of doing a sister episode while she's here. I don't know exactly when we'll do it and post it, etc. So but we are planning on doing a sister episode. I hope that's everything. If not, we'll catch up next time. I did get some other things in the mail, and I decided to just hold off for now. So, I will talk to you guys all next time with Tiff. Talk to you later. Bye.
Hi. I also was going to tell you that Hillary, Hippie Penguin, is getting married, and several of us donated knit flowers to make a beautiful knit bouquet for her and surprise her. So, Heather, Bucho's babe, is the one who gathered the flowers and made the bouquet. So I'll show a picture of the flowers I donated along with a picture of the completed bouquet that she was surprised with. So, bye!
Saturday is the smile on Mona Lisa's face. A little spare change given to the stranger on the corner. A pile of leaves deep enough for my soul to jump into, and all my doubts fall away and lead me here to say it's a beautiful day. Beautiful.